Oh, well done. You've managed to fix the magic orb on your own. Thanks a lot. Now we can rest assured the gifts will reach the children safe and sound. I never imagined Lenny would betray me like that. The Guardians of Christmas always treated him well and gave him a chance to fulfill his potential. What were his motives? I believe we should follow Lenny's trail and try to figure out what actually happened. Letting Lenny go would be dangerous. Who knows what else might occur? Please prepare everything you need for our journey. First of all, get some skates. The ice on the river is extremely slippery. I'll wait here for you, and take this. I'm sure you'll find it useful.
Get out of here, quick! It's too dangerous to stay in this place! Run!
Oh, thanks for putting on such a great show. You really had me entertained this whole time. You've fallen into my trap like a fly in a web. Good girl Frosty fooled you into believing Lenny was the culprit and led you on a wild goose chase, and you halfwits never even doubted her honesty. Ah, and it looks like Santa has wasted all his magic snow on trying to light up the path for his sleighs. Well, gullibility has a high price to pay. Say goodbye to Granddad, little buddy, and this is only the beginning. Mark my words, the best is yet to come.
Come now, kid. Don't be scared of me. I'm not your enemy. Frosty slandered me and made me look like an utter scoundrel to try and divert suspicion from herself. This whole time, I've actually been attempting to thwart Ambrose's plan. He seemed suspicious to me for quite a while, so I've been keeping an eye on him. Before long, I realized my hunch was right. Ambrose was indeed plotting against Santa. Sadly, the other Guardians of Christmas didn't share my suspicion. I was forced to act alone. I assumed Ambrose was planning to deface Santa's toys, so I delayed their shipment and even damaged the magic orb to halt the sleighs. But instead of destroying toys, Ambrose abducted Santa himself. Let's send up a flare and call for help. I used to have one with me, but I must have dropped it on the way to this cave.
Nice to meet you, my young friend. I'm Florence the Fairy. I've been flying around this icy wasteland looking for you. Sending up that flare was a smart move. Now that we've finally found each other, I'll tell you what Ambrose is up to. But first, I'd like to apologize to you, Lenny. It was terribly wrong of me to mistrust you. It's not too late to stop Ambrose yet, but we must act quickly. While you and Santa were following Lenny's trail, Ambrose managed to snatch the Star of Oblivion. It's an extremely powerful artifact created by an evil sorceress many years ago. Armed with it, spellcasters can instantly erase from humanity whichever memories they please. Ambrose is going to put the Star of Oblivion on the tallest Christmas tree in the land. As soon as that artifact illuminates the city, people will forget about Santa for good. We should harness our reindeer and head straight to Hopeville. That's where we'll find the tallest Christmas tree. I'll fly in front of the sleigh and show you the way. Oh, and one more thing. Did you know that the icy cave you were trapped in was once inhabited by the Snow Queen and her retinue? Well, now you do. The Snow Queen had a magic mirror that allowed her to explore the memories of any living creature. All she had to do was touch its cold glass and think of the person she was curious about. How about you use that mirror to unveil the mystery of Ambrose's past? It should help us develop a better understanding of his motives. You've made the right decision. The magic mirror is still in the icy cave. You can't miss it.